So I had just joined BNI in Alabama. I was 24 years of age. I was a business coach, and I had just come out of construction project management. And I joined a chapter in BNI in Northern Alabama, in Huntsville, Alabama. And I dressed like a construction project manager, which is, you never want to, like, I never wanted to look like a woman on the construction site. And so I wore khaki pants and collared shirts, and I didn't wear makeup, and my hair was blunt cut, and it was probably in a ponytail most of the time. And then I shifted from being that to being a business coach. Well, what do you picture as being a successful business coach looking like? Well, not a construction project manager. So two ladies, Terry and Terry, gave me quite the gift. They sat me down after hours. I believe there might have been a drink involved. And they sat me down, and literally, the short part of the story is they told me I wasn't referable. And they said, you know, you're not referable. And luckily for me in that moment, I said, what are we going to do about it? Like, you're not going to give me this feed. You're not going to give me this feedback and then like leave me here to sit and figure it out, because that I was not going to figure it out. And so I said, what are we going to do about it? And that went to the, okay, we got to get your hair. We got to do something with your hair. You got to consult with the cosmetics and skincare person in our chapter. And Terry Ledbetter actually, let me go shopping in her closet until she could actually take me shopping. And I show up at my next BNI chapter meeting in a suit, with my hair done, with my makeup done, like completely made over. And literally, like, people are like, what happened to you? And I said, Terry and Terry got a hold of me. And they said, oh, yeah. Well, so fast forward months, not even year, fast forward months, I had the opportunity to become the executive director of BNI, and I happened to vent to the one person about having trouble finding the financing, because BNI is a franchise organization. And I happened to vent to one person who could help me, and he actually said, and that was Bob Crook, and he said to me, Megan, I believe you'd be an amazing executive director, and I'll loan you the money to do it. And I went back recently and I talked to Terry and Jerry, and I said, do you think that Bob would have invested in me if I had not obviously been able to take feedback? And they said, no way. They said, there is no way that he would have invested in you prior to seeing, like, you're going to be a growing professional, and you're going to continue to grow, and you're going to continue to get better. And so this is somebody that I'd be willing to bet on, which was just stunning. At the time, I mean, it was just absolutely shocking. And then that was 14 years ago. 14 years ago. The other thing that I think I want to say is that feedback is a gift. It's absolutely a gift. If you take it and you use it, it's the most amazing gift. And I think many of us feel like it's criticism, or it's you're telling me there's something wrong. It's a gift. Because easily in my story, they could have said that to somebody else. They could have never said it to me, and I would have never known that that was my challenge, my one little challenge. But instead they decided to share it with me, and they made the effort. I mean, when somebody gives you feedback, it's coming from a caring place. It really is coming from a caring place. So take it, use it.